Many thanks for staying with us. Remember, today is World Sight Day, and this year's theme is Make Vision Cap. Whether it is glaucoma, diabetes, eye care, management, or cataract, the doctor is here to tell us all about it. Do stay with us. It is time to meet with the doctor. Hello again. I've been joined by a consultant ophthalmologist to discuss the World Sight Day. And please join me to say hello and welcome to Dr. Mrs. Rita Momo. It's good to have you.
Thank you very much.
On today's broadcast.
Thank you.
I've heard about so much, indeed, thank you. Mm-hmm. We've heard about so much activities ongoing for the World Sight Day, so I'm wondering. First of all, let's look at a general overview of eye care.
Okay.
Yes. What about it?
I say it is one of the most important sense organs of the body because it subserves the aspect of sight. So that is what helps us to see and appreciate the beautiful world that we live in. So it's a very important organ in our body, and we have to do well to take care of the eyes. So the eye care, you're asking me about eye care in general in the country. Right now, eye care is pretty much structured in both the public and private sectors, health sectors, I would say. We have the tertiary hospitals. Many of them offer and render eye care services because many of them would have an eye department. So also with the general hospitals, many of them, and a number of other government hospitals may offer eye care.
Are the most common eye, diseases or ailments we have around, especially in Edo Delta region?
Okay. Eye care problems are quite prevalent in the community, in our community and generally world over. The world figures, the data have it that we have over 285 million people who are either blind or visually impaired in the whole world. And then in Nigeria, luckily, we also have data that has been given to us by the Nigerian Blindness Survey that was done about 10 years ago. They have been able to also tell us that about 42 out of 1,000 persons in Nigeria are either blind or visually impaired. So that is a huge number, that's a huge number. So it means out of about 100 people going around, 4 of them are either blind or visually impaired. And the majority of them that are blind from cataract. Cataract is the number one major cause of blindness in Nigeria and indeed in the whole world, because it constitutes up to about 50% of the causes of blindness among the people that are blind. Then following cataract is a condition called glaucoma. Glaucoma is the disease of the optic nerve that causes progressive and irreversible blindness. Okay, so that one is also responsible for up to 13% of blindness, okay, among the causes of blindness. So these are the major ones. Then we have things like corneal blindness, people that are blind from corneal problems, mostly children, maybe from measles, vitamin A deficiency, or even use of harmful traditional eye medications in the eye, causing, you know, they can result in infections of the eye that will eventually lead to blindness in the children. That is another huge number that we are having, especially in developing the world.
Yeah.
Then also coming up strongly on the list of the causes of blindness is blindness related to diabetes mellitus, what we call diabetic retinopathy. You know, Nigeria has a huge population, and you know, as we age more, life expectancy is becoming higher and better. You know, many of these conditions, diseases are age-related, and they now start to show up. So diabetic retinopathy is also coming up as a common cause of blindness, even among amongst Nigerians, you know. Then there are some other things that we've actually dealt with them. Those ones used to be higher up on the list. We are talking about blindness due to trachoma and onchocerciasis, but we've dealt with them effectively over the past 30 to 40 years. So they are really now low down on the list. Those are infectious causes of blindness. So now we are starting to deal with more with the non-communicable causes of blindness, like cataract, glaucoma. Those ones are high, just high up there. And diabetic retinopathy, you know. So those are the major causes of blindness that are prevalent. Then another cause of visual impairment. Now, a major cause of visual impairment is refractive error, uncorrected refractive errors. You find that a huge number of people, over 50% of persons who have blindness, visual impairment from the data, actually have uncorrected refractive error, which means that they just need simple tests and to be prescribed the appropriate glasses, and their visual impairment to be corrected.
Really?
They will not be able to see. Mm-hmm. So there's a huge number of such persons around that have a uncorrected refractive error that just need spectacles.